compliance with Chapter 231 of the Open Public Meeting Act of the State of New Jersey, adequate notice has been given to all members of the governing body, the local source, and the Westfield Leader, the two newspapers designated to receive such notice. This notice is also posted on the Borough Hall bulletin board. Let's stand for an invocation from Councilman Mattachak.
Dear Lord, thank you for bringing us together tonight. Help guide us to make the best decisions for our community. Look after our first responders as they bravely look after us. Also look after our military as they protect our country and promote peace around the world. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Martha, roll call, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Here.
Councilman Dierkes?
Renee?
Yes, here.
Councilman Mattachak?
Here.
Councilman Messler is absent. Councilwoman Pacifico?
Here.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Here.
Okay, first we have the approval of the minutes of the regular and executive session meeting on February 20th, 2024.
So move. Second.
We have a motion. We have a second. Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Mattachak?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
Next, we have the approval of the minutes of the work session meeting on March 5th, 2024.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion. We have a second. Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Mattachak?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
Before we get to the police awards, we have some members of the Mountainside Elks who are here tonight that are going to be awarding some checks to some of our local organizations that they got as grants from the National Elks Foundation. So we have John Cazale, who's the ER, and we have Lisa Plesch, who is our secretary, and she's chairman of the grants committee. Why don't you guys come forward? The first one is a check for the rescue squad. Where's Eric? Is he here? Yeah, he's here somewhere.
It's Chris and Domenico. No, that's okay, Kim.
Lisa's. Gotta speak up, John. We know you can speak up.
On the behalf of Mountainside Elks, I'd like to thank you for your efforts and everything you do for the community. And this is how we'd like to respond back. And thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
By the way, it's a check for $4,000.
Nice.
They're going to use it for their heart monitor that they want to buy. Correct, guys?
Yes.
Okay. Next, we have the VFW. Bob Lenihan's going to accept that check.
All the veterans in Mountainside that have officer. I've been a member of this post for since about 2017. And I joined because my daughter moved to Mountainside. And as a young veteran, I went to welcoming me home when I came home from 4 years of service with the Army and a year in Vietnam. And Mountainside has been different. It's supported the Memorial Day Parade, Veterans Day Parade, presentations at Deerfield School, the banners that you guys fly on behalf of all of us that have served. And it's been a different experience and a really great experience. And so I think this donation is a real reflection of the commitment of Mountainside to the veterans. Appreciate it very much. You're welcome.
Next one is the Mountainside PAL.
Paul, Mayor. Chrissy's here.
Oh, Chrissy's here?
Good idea.
Good for
Thanks,
you.
Chrissy. That's also $1,000, and that's for their contribution to the Memorial Day Parade, which Bob spoke of before. Thank you, John and Lisa.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Okay, at this time, I'm going to turn the program over to our chief. Joe, you want to come forward?
I don't know why I sat down.
I'd like to welcome everybody to our 2024 awards and promotion ceremony. It's a special night. Not only are we advancing two of our police officers in rank, but we're also celebrating and acknowledging some special events and occurrences that occurred that our police officers were involved in, and some years of service milestones. And in addition, we also get to gather and meet families and spend some time together after tonight. So our first promotion is for Corporal Sforza, who will be advancing to the rank of sergeant. Officer Sforza grew up in Mountainside, attending Deerfield School and Governor Livingston High School before going to Seton Hall University, where he obtained a bachelor's degree in finance. Officer Sforza was hired by the Mountainside Police Department in December of 2016 and graduated from the John Stamler Police Academy in June of 17. Officer Sforza has spent his entire career with the police department as a member of the patrol division, having received numerous awards and accommodations. Officer Sforza helped train some of the department's recent hires as a field training officer and is currently one of two officers assigned to teach DARE to the fifth grade students in our school system. Officer Sforza is very excited for the next step in his career as sergeant in the Mountainside Police Department, a position his father held when he retired from the Rahway Police Department in 2015. So,
Joe, before we swear him in, we got to pass the resolution.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Whereas there exist vacancies in the position of sergeant and corporal in the Mountainside Police Department, whereas it is the desire of mayor and council of the borough of Mountainside to fill such vacancies with highly qualified individuals, whereas a number of eligible officers in the Mountainside Police Department have undergone extensive testing and evaluation as candidates for the position of sergeant and corporal, whereas all candidates during the selection process exemplified the high qualities and standard expected of police personnel in this community. Whereas the police committee and the police chief have recommended the promotion of two candidates whose credentials and experience were found best to suit the needs of the borough in filling these positions. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the mayor and council of the borough of Mountainside that the following individuals be promoted to sergeant and corporal in the borough of Mountainside with all the rights, responsibilities, and obligations attendant upon those positions. First is effective March 20th, 2024, Corporal William Sforza is promoted to the position of sergeant in the Mountainside Police Department. Effective also March 20th, 2024, Patrolman Nicholas Hussey is promoted to the position of corporal in the Mountainside Police Department. Now we'll swear. Sergeant Sefour is in. Before we do that, we have a motion, do we have a second?
Second.
Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajek?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
She's the closest one to get the pictures.
I, William Sforza.
I, William Sforza.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
Faith and allegiance to the same.
And to the governments established in the United States.
And to the governments established in the United States.
And in this state.
And in this state.
Under the authority of the people.
Under the authority of the people.
I do further solemnly swear.
I do further solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully.
That I will faithfully.
Impartially.
Impartially.
And justly.
And justly.
Perform all the duties of a police sergeant in the Borough of Mountainside.
Perform all the duties of a police sergeant in the Borough of Mountainside.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
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 Next, advancing to the rank of corporal is Officer Nicholas Hussey. Officer Hussey began his employment in December of 2018 after completing the alternate route program at the Morris County Police Academy. Nick served in the New Jersey National Guard as a scout or infantryman and was honorably discharged after his service. He has a bachelor's degree in justice studies from Montclair State. Now Corporal Hussey serves as a department firearms and range officer and an instructor at the Union County Police Academy as a firearms and emergency vehicle operator instructor. He is also a member of the New Jersey State PBA hockey team. His father, retired New Jersey State Trooper, was his inspiration to begin a law enforcement career, and he is here supporting Nick. So, congratulations, Nick.
I'm Nicholas Hussey. Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
And I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
And to the governments established in the United States.
And to the governments established in the United States.
And in this state.
And in this state.
Under the authority of the people.
Under the authority of the people.
I do further solemnly swear.
I do further solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully.
That I will faithfully.
Impartially.
Impartially.
And justly.
And justly.
Perform all the duties of a police corporal in the Borough of Mountainside.
Perform all duties of a police corporal in the Borough of Mountainside.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations. Joel. The slides can show you.
Come on, Dad, you can do it.
There you go.
Congratulations.
As with every promotion comes, their roles will be changing and their duties will be changing, and we're certain they will serve us well in those positions, and join me in wishing them good luck as they advance in their careers. Next, we'll get into some awards for various things that have occurred during the course of 2023, including life-saving and other things that do go on here. While we are a safe community, things do occur here, maybe not as much or as fast as they do in other communities, but our police officers are out there every day. They put themselves out there in harm's way on behalf of the community, and they absolutely deserve your trust and your respect for the job they do every day, and we thank them for that. Our first award will be for Officer Pastor and Melville for a life-saving award. If you would. On January 21st, 23, Officers Pastor and Melville were dispatched to a restaurant on Route 22 on a report of an unconscious male. Upon arrival, the officers assessed the victim and determined he was not breathing. Officer Melville began CPR while Officer Pastor prepared the AED. The officers were able to determine the victim was suffering from an apparent narcotics overdose, at which point Officer Pastor administered naloxone while Officer Melville continued chest compressions. The victim's status improved after the life-saving measures were performed by the officers, and he was ultimately transported to the hospital where he recovered from the event. Officer Pastor and Melville acted without hesitation and employed a teamwork approach during the event. Therefore, they are presented with the life-saving award. Next is another life-saving award for Officer Stoshin and Hernandez, if they would come forward. On May 25th, 2023, Officer Stoshin was dispatched to Route 22 in the area of New Providence Road for an individual in a vehicle suffering from a medical emergency. Upon arrival, Officer Stoshin observed the driver to be slumped over the steering wheel and convulsing. Officer Stoshin was able to put the vehicle in park, and with the help of a bystander, Officer Stoshin removed the male from the vehicle. Once on the ground, the victim was determined not to have a pulse, at which point Officer Stoshin began CPR. Officer Melissa Hernandez arrived on scene shortly thereafter and deployed the AED, in which two shocks were given. A pulse was then regained, and the victim was successfully transported to the hospital. For their efforts, Officer Stoshin and Officer Hernandez are awarded the Life Saving Award. Next is a rather large event that occurred here in October that involved one of our officers being dragged by a motor vehicle and injured during the event. Everybody performed amazingly during that time, and I will call up Officer Carlos, Corporal Hussey, Detective Carr, Detective Debbie, Sergeant Finer, and Officer Stoshin, please. On October 3rd, 2023, Officer Brendan Carlos performed a traffic stop on Route 22 for traffic violations. During the early stages of the traffic stop, Officer Carlos ordered the driver out of the vehicle due to him not having a driver's license. While speaking at the rear of the subject's vehicle, Corporal Nicholas Hussey arrived on scene as a backup. While trying to determine the individual's identity, the driver attempted to get back in his vehicle. Officer Carlos ordered the driver not to get back in his vehicle, to which he did not listen. A physical struggle ensued between Officer Carlos and a suspect, with the suspect ultimately being able to regain entry into his vehicle. The suspect then put the vehicle into drive and accelerated at a high rate of speed, causing Officer Carlos to be dragged for approximately 50 feet along Route 22. Officer Carlos was sent tumbling from the vehicle and sustained injuries to his extremities. The suspect was successfully able to evade capture by police until the Mountainside Detective Bureau personnel arrived on scene to process and investigate. Through a collaborative investigative process with the Union and Bergen County Prosecutor's Office, Detective Ryan Carr and James Debbie were able to positively identify the suspect. With the assistance of Springfield Police, the suspect's vehicle was located in Irvington and a surveillance was placed on the vehicle. Detective Debbie drafted the arrest warrant, while Detective Carr and Sergeant Finer and Officer Stoshin and the Union County Prosecutor's Office converged on the location of the suspect was believed to be staying. The officers then made entry into the residence and arrested the individual, charging him with various aggravated assault and other criminal charges. Officer Carlos was treated for his injuries and has since made a full recovery. This incident speaks to the inherent dangers our officers face every day, as well as the strength of teamwork and collaboration in getting the job done. For their efforts, Officer Carlos and Corporal Hussey are awarded a commendation, while Detective Debbie, Detective Carr, Sergeant Finer, and Officer Stoshin are awarded an Excellent Police Service Award.
Scooching, guys.
As a side note to that event, the suspect was arrested using Officer Carlos's handcuffs and is currently serving a 7-year prison sentence for his actions that day. So, next we'll call up Sergeant Norton, Sergeant Yasinski, Corporal Hagen, Officer Melville, Pastor, Stoshin, and Hernandez. On October 22nd, 2023, Officers Melville, Pastor, Corporal Hagen, and Sergeant Norton were dispatched to the Watchung Reservation on a report of a missing 14-year-old with autism. The young lady was visiting the reservation with family when she unexpectedly ran away from the group. The Union County Police Department and the Mountainside Police Department, with the assistance of the Union County Sheriff's Department and Berkeley Heights Police Department, engaged in a coordinated search effort. Sergeant Andrew Yasinski, Officer Timothy Sashin, and Officer Melissa Hernandez joined the search efforts. During the search, Mountainside officers on foot searched many acres of heavily wooded terrain and darkening conditions. With temperatures on a quick decline, time was of the essence to ensure the missing person's well-being. Our officers searched the area for approximately 7 hours, and the young lady was finally found in good health. For their dedication in the search, the officers are awarded a unit citation. Both myself and Captain Jackson responded in on that event, and the young special needs girl was not dressed for the weather. The weather was declining, and our officers made a great effort searching backyards, sheds, and showed great concern for the well-being of that girl. So,
thank you.
Next, we'll call up Officer Carlos. On November 10th, 2023, Officer Carlos was patrolling on Route 22 when he conducted a patrol stop on a vehicle for motor vehicle violations. During the course of the traffic stop, Officer Carlos noticed a firearms magazine in the glove box of the vehicle, at which point he radioed for backup and ordered the driver to place his hands on the steering wheel. Once Corporal Sforza and Sergeant Feiner arrived on scene, the suspect was removed from the vehicle and was found to be illegally in possession of a fully loaded Glock 19 handgun he had in his waistband. The individual did not have a concealed carry permit for the handgun and was carrying a firearm in a very dangerous manner. For his seizure of an unlawfully possessed firearm from our streets, he is awarded a commendation. Next, we'll call up Officer Melville, Corporal Hagen, and Sergeant Norton for a life-saving award. On December 10th, 2023, Officer Melville, Corporal Hagen, and Sergeant Norton were dispatched to a residence on a report of a male possibly choking. Officers arrived on scene to find the patient was turning blue and was not alert. Officers began CPR and were able to successfully regain a pulse. The individual was later transported to the hospital for further evaluation. For their life-saving efforts, the officers are awarded a life-saving award. Again, we thank our officers for the job they do every day. Every day they're out there not only addressing crime, but also preventing crime and keeping everything very low and safe here. And as a chief, I thank them for their efforts during the course of the year. Next, we'll acknowledge some years of service. Having obtained 15 years of service is Lieutenant Bendick and Sergeant Feiner, if they would come up, please. Having reached 10 years of service, we call up Detective Debbie, please. For having attained 5 years of service, we call up Corporal Hagen, Corporal Hussey, and Corporal Pierre. All right, that concludes our award ceremony. I'd like to thank everybody for attending. I'd like to thank everybody for their efforts, and I'm sure we'll continue to get great policing out of them in the years to come. And good luck to our promotees, and I'm sure you'll do a great job for the borough.
Thank you. On behalf of myself and the whole council, as well as our whole community, I want to thank these fine officers for the great job that they do in keeping our town safe, not only in performing the actions that they got awards for tonight, but day in and day out, they're checking on seniors, they're watching out for our kids, they're making this town very safe, and I want to thank them all for doing that. Thank you. Now, at this point, you can all stay for the rest of our meeting if you would like. But if you don't like, you can leave.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good night.
Good night. I need some other sides of this now.
Hey, Joe.
It's all right.
Are they going to the Elks?
Yeah, they're going to the Elks.
Oh, that's cool.
I won't be left with nobody.
National Foundation. We apply for grants.
Is that right?
Yeah.
The National Foundation gives them grants.
They have tons of money. That's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
They're good.
Oh my gosh, I know.
And they hound you to give it away. I was getting email after email. You filed the thing. It was wrong. You got to correct it. Don't miss out on the funds. Happy birthday, Karen. Thank you, Bob. That was a nice little speech you gave.
That was a good kid. That was a good guy.
Okay, guys, let's get started now. Next, we have Resolution 42-2024. Donna, that's you.
Resolution 42-2024, whereas the Borough of Mountainside needs to refund monies to interested parties for overpayment of current tax years. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the treasurer be authorized to issue the following refund for $2,756.86 for the resident at 1571 Brookside Road. So moved.
Second.
We have a motion. We have a second. Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajek?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Rinaldo?
Yes.
Next, we have Resolution 43-2024. Don?
Whereas NJSA 40A:40-58 provides for transfers within certain appropriations within the reserve municipal budget during the first 3 months of the fiscal year, and whereas the Chief Financial Officer has advised the Mayor and Council and the Board of Mountainside the need to make certain transfers exists. Whereas it is recommended that these budget transfers be made, therefore be it resolved to make the following budget transfers. Police SW 20,000, or from police SW 20,000, and from clerk 1,002 Public Works OE and Water, matching amounts totaling $21,000. So moved.
Second.
We have a motion. We have a second. Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajek?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
Next, we have Resolution 44-2024. Renee, that's you.
Yes, this allows the borough to make some temporary appropriations, and this will be for things like the rescue squad, the public library, and road work. So moved.
We have a motion. We have a second? Second? Anyone?
Second.
Second. Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajek?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
Next, we have Resolution 45-2024. Deanna?
We have refunds for a road opening permit on the amount of $1,500. So moved.
Second.
Motion and a second. Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajek?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
Next, we have Resolution 46-2024. Steve?
Whereas the Borough of Mountainside has a need to acquire professional services as a non-fair and open contract pursuant to the provisions of NJSA 1944A-20.5, and whereas the anticipated term of this contract is 1 year, and whereas John H. Norton, Esquire, from law offices of John N. Norton, LLC, has submitted a proposal in February indicating they will provide labor attorney services for the borough at a cost not to exceed $40,000. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the mayor and council of the borough of Mountainside authorizes borough officials to enter into a contract with John H. Norton from law offices of John N. Norton, LLC, as described herein. Be it further resolved that the business disclosure entity certification and a determination of the value be placed on file with this resolution, and be it further resolved that award of this contract be published in the appropriate newspaper within 10 days hereof. So moved.
Okay, we got a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajek?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
Okay, next we have Resolution 47-2024. Deanna?
Whereas there is a need for a part-time violations clerk in the court department. Whereas Jessica Einstein Kaufman can perform the duties of part-time violations clerk, and therefore be it resolved by the mayor and council of the borough of Mountainside that Jessica Einstein Kaufman is hereby hired as a part-time violations clerk in the court department at an hourly rate of $23, not to exceed 20 hours unless approved advance by the administrator. So moved.
Second.
We got a motion. We have a second. Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajek?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
Next, we have Resolution 48-2024. Steve?
Whereas NJSA 40A-9-141 provides that every municipality provide for the appointment of a municipal tax collector, and whereas the Borough of Mountainside has determined that Sandra Bruns possesses the necessary tax collector license to serve as the tax collector of the Borough of Mountainside, and whereas NJSA 40A-9-142 states that every municipal tax collector shall hold their office for a term of 4 years from the first day of January next following their appointment. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the mayor and council of the borough of Mountainside that Sandra Bruns is appointed as part-time tax collector effective May 1st, 2024 for a four-year term commencing January 1, 2025 and running through December 31st, 2028 with an annual salary of $25,000 with $5,000 of the $25,000 being designated as compensation to continue with the mentoring of the new chief financial officer. So moved.
Motion. We have a second.
Second.
Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajek?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
Okay, next we have Resolution 49-2024.
Whereas NJSA 40A:4-78B has authorized the local finance board to adopt rules that permit municipalities in sound fiscal condition to assume the responsibility normally granted to the director of the Division of the Local Government Services of conducting the annual budget examination, and whereas NJAC 530-7 was adopted, whereas pursuant to NJAC 5:30-7.2 through 7.5, the borough has been declared eligible to participate. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the mayor and council that in accordance with NJAC 530-7.6A and B, based on the chief financial officer certification, that with reference to the following items, the amounts have been calculated pursuant to law and appropriated as such in the budget. That the provisions relating to limitation and increases of appropriations and appropriations for exceptions to limits on appropriations are fully met. That the budget is in such form, arrangement, and content as required by the local budget law. Pursuant to the local budget law, all estimates of revenue are reasonable, accurate, and correctly stated. Items of appropriation are properly set forth in itemization form and arrangement content. The budget will permit the exercise of the comptroller function within the municipality. The budget and associate amendments have been introduced, public advertised, and adopted in accordance with the budget law. That all other applicable statutory requirements have been fulfilled. Be it further resolved, a copy of this resolution be forwarded to the Director of the Division of Local Government Services. Certification of approved budget. It is hereby certified that the approved budget complies with the requirements in law. An approval is given pursuant to NJSA 40A:4-78B and NJAC 5:30-7. It is further certified that the municipality has met the eligibility requirements of NJAC 5:37.4 and 7.5, and that chief financial officer of the borough of Mountainside, having completed the local examination in compliance with NJAC 5:30-7.6. So moved.
Thanks,
Don. We have a motion. We have a second.
Second.
Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajak?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
And Don passed his first test tonight.
He certainly did.
Next, we have Resolution 50-2024. Donna.
Resolution 50-2024, whereas the council is recommending compensation adjustments as followed. Council members $3,000, mayor $5,000. Now, therefore, be resolved that this compensation becomes effective upon adoption of this resolution. So moved.
We have a motion. We have a second.
Second.
Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajak?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
Okay, next we have some ordinances. The first one is Ordinance 1327-2024. Donna, you're going to take care of that.
This ordinance was for calendar year 2024. This ordinance is to establish a cap bank, whereas the local government cap law, New Jersey, S40A:4-451, provides that in the preparation of the annual budget, a municipality shall limit any increase in said final budget appropriations to 2.5% unless authorized by ordinance to increase it to 3.5% over the previous year's final appropriations. So moved.
We have a motion. We have a second. Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajak?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
Okay, next we have, that was the ordinance. Did we forget the resolution for the introduction of the budget?
No, you have to pass the panel.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's do ordinance 1329.
Resolution.
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 51-2024. Resolution 51-2024. Steve. I don't know why I'm messing this up tonight.
Municipal budget of the Borough of Mountainside, County of Union for the calendar year 2024. Be it resolved that the following statements of revenues and appropriations shall constitute the municipal budget for the year 2024. And be it further resolved that said budget summaries be published in a local source in the issue of March 28, 2024. And the governing body of the Borough of Mountainside does hereby approve the following as the budget for the year 2024. The hearing on the budget and tax resolution will be held on April 16th, 2024 at 7:30 p.m., at which time and place objections to said budget and tax resolution for year 2024 may be presented by taxpayers or other interested persons. So moved.
Second.
Before we vote on it, I'd like to just give a brief summary of the increases and decreases in the expenses as well as the increases in our revenue. Overall salaries increased $234,490. A lot of that has to do with the police promotions. The DPW operating budget went up $30,000. That's mainly because of our recycling contract. The fire department budget is going up $21,000. The operating budget for the police department is going up $14,750. The operating budget for legal is going up $10,000. Operating budget for all other departments is $1,990. Group insurance and waivers, one of our bigger increases, is $66,000. Also, other insurance, which is our GIF fund, also is a substantial increase. That was $60,000. Utilities went up $13,000. Board of Health contract went up $5,000. Social Security went up $20,000. Our pool deficit was $15,500. We have capital purchases of $221,500, but that increase is offset by an increase in the use of the surplus for these capital purchases. Debt obligations increased by $543. Our PERS pension went up $130,476.36. Again, another cost that we don't control, but it was a big part of our budget. The PERS contribution pension obligation was also the PFRS pension obligations, which is the police, was $130,460. The rest of the pension obligation was increased $20,201. Our capital improvement fund went up by $60,000. Our pending tax appeal decreased by $50,000. Purchase of vehicles also went down $40,000. And our grant matches went down $4,695. We had some helpful revenues, which helped offset these increases. As I indicated before, we're using some of the surplus for our capital purchases. We have our municipal relief fund increased by $40,024. Our increase in cable franchise fees, $1,181, and energy receipts went up $3,847. Bottom line is we have an increase in the 2024 municipal budget of $563,201.58. Basically, what that means to the our taxpayers, the average assessed home in Mountainside is $629,424, for the average assessed home. Based upon the increase, each person's taxes will go up $159.87. Okay, so at this point, poll the council.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajak?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Rinaldo?
Yes.
Okay, so now we can pass ordinance 1329-2024, and that would be Don. That's you.
It's I. Okay.
An ordinance amending Chapter 7-17 of the Borough Code by adding a provision for temporary parking permits. Whereas it appears the governing body that property owners in the borough may be denied the ability to rent otherwise available spaces in their parking lots for temporary use because of such rentals are not authorized by their land use or site plan approvals. Whereas the governing body has determined it is in the best interests of the borough, now so be it ordained by the mayor and council of the borough of Mountainside that Section 1, Chapter 7, Section 17 of the Mountainside Borough Code be, and the same is hereby amended to delete from the chapter heading the word residential, so that the chapter heading would read 7-17 permit parking, and the insertion in Chapter 7-17 of the following new section, temporary parking permits. Permit requirements. On occasion, it may be necessary and appropriate to permit parking activities for a limited period of time under very specific conditions, which might otherwise be prohibited by the borough's land development ordinance. Authority to issue temporary parking permit and an application form. Application for temporary parking permit shall be made on a form provided by the zoning officer. Consideration to be paid by the owner or lessor of the property where the temporary parking would occur for such temporary parking. Any ordinance or portions thereof which are inconsistent with the provisions of this ordinance are hereby repealed as of the date of this ordinance. If any provision of this ordinance or the application of such provision to any person or circumstance is declared invalid, such invalidity shall not affect the other provisions. This ordinance shall take effect immediately upon final passage and publication as provided by law. So moved.
Okay, we got a motion. We have a second.
Second.
Poll the council, please.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajek?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
We skipped over ordinance 1328-2024. Steve, you want to take that?
Yeah, thanks, Mayor. Ordinance 1328-2024, bond ordinance to authorize the undertaking of various infrastructure improvements in and for the borough of Mountainside in the County of Union, State of New Jersey, to appropriate the sum of $1 million to pay the cost thereof, to make a down payment, to authorize the issuance of bonds to finance such appropriations, and to provide for the issuance of bond anticipation notes in anticipation of the issuance of such bonds. So moved.
We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
Poll the council.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Matajek?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
Okay, so now we need to pay the bills. Renee?
Sure. Hold on one second. Just give me one second.
would you like me to get someone on the dais here to take that for you?
No. I have it here.
Yes.
That ordinance. But anyway, don't worry. Be it resolved by the mayor and council of the borough of Mountainside that the following bills in the persons named and for the amount stated below have been duly audited, and funds be found to be correct for the 19th day of March 2024. The same be paid after council review, if and when funds were available, and that the mayor, council president, administrator, treasurer are hereby authorized and directed to sign and deliver warrants for the same, and that's in the amount of $747,213.14. So moved.
We have a motion. We have a second. Yes, a second.
Second.
Poll the council.
Councilwoman Andre.
It's 747,203.
It's $10 difference.
Yeah. Oh, so let's correct it.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
What happened?
We're going to amend the motion to read that the total bills are $747,203.14.
Thank you.
So we have a Renee, you're going to make the motion as amended?
Yes, so moved.
Second.
And we have a second. Now poll the council.
Councilwoman Andre?
Yes.
Councilman Dierkes?
Yes.
Councilman Mattajak?
Yes.
Councilwoman Pacifico?
Yes.
Councilman Ronaldo?
Yes.
Sorry about that, Renee. Okay, so next we have any council comments?
Mayor, I do.
Okay.
I'd like to echo the chief of the Mountainside Rescue Squad. Thank you for being here, but I'd like to echo his words. I am beyond proud to share that 6 Mountainside Rescue Squad EMTs have been approved to join the New Jersey EMS Task Force, as well as the Mountainside Rescue Squad being approved to become a host agency. For this round of approvals, there were over 90 applications for 51 spots, and I am proud to say that we have the largest group from a single volunteer agency. It is a true testament to the dedication, professionalism, and the skill that all of my EMTs uphold. Thank you. I echo his words.
That's great.
I'd also ask Domenico to come up and just remind us of the Easter egg hunt that is going to be held at the Rescue Squad. Can you give us a little bit more detail of the time, day?
Well, I do have a question, though. It's supposed to rain Saturday. Is there a rain date for this?
There is not.
Yeah, the whole weekend it's supposed to
you
rain.
You can turn around.
My name is Domenico DeLuca. I'm a lieutenant at the Rescue Squad. Our annual Easter egg hunt is going to be this Saturday, the 23rd at noon. If there is any changes due to the weather, we will be posting it on our Facebook page. Thank you.
Thank you
so much. No more comments from me.
I have some. So we have a very sizable and active senior community here in Mountainside. And to accommodate them, we have lots of events. It's more than I can get into all the details of, but I'm going to hit some of the highlights. And if anyone wants any more information, I encourage you to visit our borough website where you can find information or contact information from our senior coordinator or the recreation department. We have a community room, which is open, and we have various health and fitness classes. We have a senior gym that's open weekdays. Again, check the borough website for times. We have a senior van that is available. We have events at the Rescue Squad. We have events at the library. We have a technology workshop. Bring your device and get ready to learn about it. We have stretch classes, bagels and bingo, library focus groups, line dancing, tour of Ireland historical lectures, historical true crime presentation. So there's a lot for a lot of different interests, whether it's fitness or something intellectual. Also, free trees. We do this periodically to help replant communities damaged by Superstorm Sandy with free tree seedlings. Seedlings planted today will create forests for the future. The seedlings will be available at the Borough of Mountainside DPW garage Saturday, April 13th. From 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. If you have any questions, call the DPW at 232-2409. There's 450 seedlings available, so first come, first serve, come early. Lastly, we have a small but very active DPW department who does a lot of work around town in inclement weather, working with machinery that's either small or very large, and it's important that they remain safe. For the first time ever, they have achieved a perfect score from the Suburban Insurance Fund, a score of 100 out of 100 for the first time ever. So congratulations to the department led by Matt Deanna. Good work.
Any other council comments? I have one. Our fire department was awarded a $50,000 grant from the American Rescue Plan Firefighters Grant. With that, we will be purchasing 13 new turnout gears for our firefighters. So congratulations to the fire department. Okay, we are going to have an executive session. Yes?
Yeah, John has a few things.
Oh. Give me my cheat sheet, please.
What
Potential litigation.
What?
Potential litigation.
Sorry. Everyone off guard tonight. The police awards just overwhelmed us. Okay, so whereas the Open Public Meeting Act of the State of New Jersey permits the public to be excluded from certain matters to be discussed by the governing body. Whereas the mayor and council desire to discuss litigation, contracts, and personnel, which are matters where the exclusion of the public is permitted, whereas public disclosure of the results of this discussion will be made as soon as the matters discussed have been resolved by the governing body of the Borough of Mountainside. Now therefore be it resolved by the mayor and council of the Borough of Mountainside that the aforesaid matter shall be discussed in closed session and its potential litigation. So we need a motion to go into closed session.
Second.
Okay, so we're going to go in closed session in about 2 minutes.
I started at the Stage House in Scotch Plains about 17, 18 years ago as the sous chef. I grew to be the chef de cuisine before I left. I had left the company because I wanted to be an executive chef, and Eric, who's one of the partners, was the exec chef at the time, so I was never gonna get that position from him. So I left to be an executive chef elsewhere. And then when they opened the Somerset location, they called me back, asked me to come and be the opening executive chef there. I was there for about 4.5 years or so. Then I actually left the company again. And then when they opened up here, they needed some help and they reached out to me to come here and be the chef and offered me a partnership to keep me for the long term this time. So Mountainside, we opened here in February of 2017. It's the third venture for the group, and it was, we took over a banquet hall. So we have this gigantic space to fill. So, we've come to be creative, utilizing different parties, and banquets are still a huge part of what we do. I've never had a bigger restaurant in my life. The kitchen's the biggest I've ever had in my life. It's a huge space. The core of our mission statement is to provide incredible value in a beautiful setting. And that's what we strive to do. We do a little bit of everything, which makes us unique in that sense. You can come here and we have Neapolitan style pizza. We have sushi. We make all of our own pasta and ravioli in-house. We're doing things like making sausage and a lot of things like that that a lot of restaurants typically don't do anymore, especially more casual restaurants like ourselves. So, we consider ourselves a casual family restaurant, but at the same time, we remember our roots as a fine dining restaurant in Scotch Plains, and we take a lot of those principles and techniques and introduce that into our more casual menu that we do these days. One thing that we've worked very hard to do, especially now, it's actually on our marquee right now, is that we're fighting back against inflation and come see our new menu. So, as we all know, everybody who goes grocery shopping or does anything these days, it's a struggle. So, we've decided that instead of continuing to raise prices to combat the rising costs of everything, we've tried to find creative ways to produce the same quality food that we are known for, but at a lower cost. And therefore we can pass on that value that we strive for to the customer. So we've actually created a menu in which we now have over 100 dishes that are about $25 or less. And we've got, I think about 80 of them are even under $20. So we've tried to make it so that people, can come out more often and still receive that same great value and a great meal, but not break the bank. I absolutely love our pasta and ravioli. Obviously, that's something that we've grown to be known for over the years since we started making the pasta and ravioli in Scotch Plains years ago. We actually produce all the pasta and ravioli here for all three stage houses. So that's something that we always pride ourselves on. And then You know, our burgers and steaks are all great because we have a very unique wood-burning grill. I have a 7-foot wood-burning grill, so anything that comes off of our grill has a very unique smoky flavor to it that you really don't get anywhere else. So those are some of the things that we really take pride in that we, you know, that kind of separate us from others. You know, we have a giant smoker back there, so I really love our entire barbecue program, our ribs, our pulled pork. We now make our own pastrami. Even our wings, I absolutely love because we smoke them, so they're a little different than, you know, your typical wings that you go out and get at other places. We have a very large, obviously, for a restaurant this big, we have a big staff. So obviously with a big staff comes a lot of diversity. So it's great. We employ a lot of college kids these days. That's the one thing that I think the pandemic changed a little bit is a lot of the lifers in this industry are no longer here. So we, you know, now it's a lot of college kids who are either just finished college and still looking for their full-time career, or people who are trying to make some money while they're in classes. There's some people that have come from other locations that have been with the company for, you know, 15 years. And just people who really enjoy this industry, and really we strive to create an atmosphere and a culture that people are happy to be here and they're having fun and they are enjoying coming to work rather than it just being a job. So every weekend we do live music, actually 4 days a week now. On Thursdays we have usually an acoustic set during dinner, that's from 5 to 8. So it'll be either a solo or a duo. Artists really, and we really strive to only book really, really talented people that we've worked with before. And that's usually like lighter background dinner music. And then on Fridays and Saturdays, we alternate either a live band or a DJ on either night. So there's always some form of live entertainment on weekends. And then on Sundays during our large brunch buffet, which is also extremely popular, we do a blues band every brunch. So we call it Blues Brunch. And every Sunday we have the same blues band here. And they are excellent, a lot of fun. People love coming here and, you know, celebrating their occasions. The band will do the happy birthday song and all, and just really have a lot of fun with it. You know, we are the stage house. We have a giant stage here, so we try to utilize that as much as possible. So yeah, the live music brings a lot of people on the weekends, and we book some really, really excellent bands here. I enjoy the ability to do so many different things. What makes us unique is that we're not kind of pigeonholed into anything, you know, especially from a chef perspective. I don't have to worry about only Italian food or only, you know, German food. We're making everything. We're making the pasta and ravioli. We're doing the pizza. We have dishes with Asian-inspired ingredients. We do dishes with, you know, Eastern European. We have pierogi and kielbasa on the menu that we make in-house. I think it's that ability to kind of be able to do so many different things that always keeps it fun and exciting. We can always play around and just kind of, we're not pigeonholed into any one cuisine or any one format, just kind of whatever, you know, we do so many different things that it always kind of keeps it fresh and fun. Well, we try to get involved as much with the community as we can. Just yesterday, we participated, which we do, you know, once every month or once a couple months, the Mountainside Seniors Meals, which we offer at a discount to the participating seniors. And, you know, we prepare a nice homemade meal from scratch at a very low cost to those who need it. You know, we recently started sponsoring the police PBA team, the softball team. You know, we try to get involved with the community as much as I can. Anybody who reaches out to us for donations or fundraisers or anything like that, we try to provide. We really just want to be that local community spot that people can go to after school events and after sporting events. And we really want to be that home that people can come, you know, literally taking the name literally. We want to be the stage house. We want to be like somebody's house that they can come to after all the events and gather and have a great meal and a great time without breaking the wallet. We really truly try to make our staff and our guests feel like family, and you know, that's very important to us and a huge part of what we do, and we really want to people to have that experience.